Hello there, Dan the Gaming Man here. Welcome to another video. Today we're going to be talking about the Amazon Prime series Fallout, which just came out a few days ago. I've spent the entire weekend watching it and I wanted to do a review video for you. This video is going to be packed full of spoilers, so I would recommend going to check the other video that I've made, which is spoiler free, card in the top right corner. If you've already seen the series and you want to hear my views on it, then stick around. And if you've not already watched the series but want to hear me talking about it, then thanks for liking my voice, I guess. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go through each episode and give you just a few thoughts on each one, talk about some of my favourite parts and anything else that I think is worth mentioning. If you enjoy the video, give it a like and consider subscribing to the channel as well. I do lots of retro gaming videos, and if you particularly like Fallout, I'm planning to do a lot more on that franchise in the future. I'm a massive fan of Fallout. I've been hooked on the game series since the third installment came out, and I own many copies of just about each one on pretty much every system possible. And I also have lots of merchandise, such as my hoodie here, and also some bobbleheads. Who doesn't love a bobblehead? Although I'm a big fan of the series, I'm by no means an expert, and although I'm sure I missed some stuff, I did pick up on one or two interesting things as I watched the season, so I will bring up those as we go through. As mentioned before, I'm going to do a full review of the series here, so we'll be going through each episode and a bit of a breakdown and a chat about each one. This isn't scripted, I do have some notes here, so I do apologise if I stumble over my words, which I just did then, and I'm going to leave that in. If I end up repeating myself a little bit, apologies for that. I think the first episode started really strong. They had a lot of nods to the game series. In that first episode, for example, we saw some bobbleheads, we saw the Pip-Boys, we saw Stimpaks and the power armor. So it was a lot of fun. One of my favorite parts was when Lucy went into one of the rooms holding a knife and she looked down at a dart gun and she had a split second to decide which one to use. I mean, we've all been there, haven't we? And I think the storyline as well really would fit into any of the games. I mean, the fact that she's going to look for her father, there was a line when somebody said, "You really look like your mother." It just felt very much like any of the Fallout games. In the third game, we have to find our father, and in the fourth one, we have to look for our son. So it wouldn't be Fallout without somebody needing to find a family member, would it? One of the things I liked as well was there was a headshot at one point, which was quite explosive. And it reminded me of, I think the perk is called, or the special is called Bloody Mess, which is one of the ones I always pick when I play the game. So I thought that was quite cool. Also, when Lucy stepped out of the vault for the first time and she's covering her eyes and the screen was very bright again, it was very reminiscent of every time you leave the vault in one of the games and you have that moment where your eyes, all the characters' eyes that you're controlling, have to adjust to the daylight. I did touch on this in my spoiler-free review. One thing that I noticed in just the first episode was how there was an over-reliance on slow motion. Whenever there was any action, it was always slowed down. And it's something that continued through the entire season. I'm not saying it's a bad thing, and I suspect it has something to do with VATS because they didn't include that in the show. But I think, do we need that every time there's action? We have to slow it down and place some Glenn Miller over the top every single time. Also, when I saw the trailer, I thought that Kyle MacLachlan was going to be a really important character. And although his role is quite pivotal to the overall story, he is only really in the first episode and then the last episode. So that was a shame because, I mean, having such a great actor on the show is brilliant. And I just think it's a bit of a shame that we didn't see more of him in the entire series. Maybe season two, obviously, well, we'll get to episode eight later, but maybe season two, we're going to see more of him. And I think that'd be a good thing. So next, let's talk about episode two. So just as I was talking about Kyle MacLachlan, similarly, in the second episode, we're introduced to another brilliant television actor, Michael Emerson, who's probably best known for Lost, where he played the villain Benjamin Linus, and he also appeared in the Saw franchise as well. It's great to have two veteran actors on the show, I think. But like MacLachlan, we don't actually get to see much of Michael Emerson, as he is killed off in this second episode. Brilliant. Lucy has now left the vault and she's exploring the landscape. There was a particularly good bit that I enjoyed where she was going through a house and I guess looting, which again is something that I've done many times on the game myself. We also get one of the funniest moments in the series, which was when Titus was fighting a bear and he starts running out the cave and starts shouting. It really made me laugh. It was hilarious because he'd been very cool up until that point in the power armor. And then suddenly he's like a small child running away from a bear. It was brilliant. Michael Emerson's character is called Wilzig, and there's a great moment where his leg was shot off. So a bit like the bloody mess that I was talking about before, again, it was a brilliant leg shot, fantastic. And this happened in a place called Philly, which was very reminiscent of Diamond City, which I think is from the fourth game in the series. At first I thought it was Diamond City, so I had a quick check online, and apparently it's not, so it's just a coincidence, but it really looked like it, didn't it? Wilzig has a dog as well, which is a very important part of any Fallout story. There has to be a dog. Obviously, my personal favourite is Dog Meat from Fallout 3. But yeah, they've all had dogs in. Unfortunately, he doesn't die. Although he does, doesn't he? And then he's brought back to life, thankfully. Also, in the second episode that I noticed something that we're going to see a lot of from Lucy, which is just her sort of naivety. It was quite enjoyable seeing her interacting with people. She doesn't have any experience of the world, and that was quite cool. Say things like golly, holy moly, and okie dokie.
Okie dokie.
It's just very, I don't know. Yeah, I enjoyed it anyway. One of my favourite moments in episode 3 was Maximus trying to haggle with a vendor who wanted 5 caps, although he only had 4. So I think he probably should have invested more in his haggle skill. Also, there's a moment where he uses the power armour to crush somebody's skull, which I really enjoyed. Although, I don't think you can do that in the game. Correct me if I'm wrong, let me know in the comments. At first I didn't really like Maximus, I thought he was a bit of a dick, to be honest. But it was in this episode where I just started to do a bit of a 180 and started to like the character a little bit more. And I think that's what's good about the series. I wouldn't really call any of them protagonists, and they're certainly not antagonists, but it's a little bit like Game of Thrones. None of the characters are really pure evil or pure good. And they're all sort of in that sort of grey area in the middle. I think that's quite a good thing. There was a particularly disgusting moment as well where, I'm not even sure what this is called, so again, let me know in the comments, that big pink monster that swallowed the head and it vomits, and it was absolutely disgusting. Also, the third episode gave us confirmation that Cooper was the original Vault Boy, not to be confused with the band Fallout Boy. It was hinted at in the opening scene of the first episode with the thumbs up stuff, but it was good to get the confirmation as it gives us a bit more lore to the Fallout universe. Episode 4, funny moments. I really enjoyed the exchange between Steph and Chet, where he's dressed up, I think, as her boyfriend or husband, and they're sort of almost getting it on the couch. She's pregnant, by the way. And her water breaks. And he says, wow, that is one wet lady. And then that scene was followed up with another brilliant exchange between Snip Snip, who's a robot voiced by the brilliant Matt Berry, where Lucy suggests that she thought she was going to be a sex slave. And he assures her that she won't be. He's just there to harvest her organs. There were some really funny lines in this episode, which I've already mentioned, but there was also a very heartbreaking part as well. A ghoul called Martha, who kept saying, I am Martha. I think she was trying to ensure she didn't become feral by reminding herself who she was. I thought it was upsetting anyway. And the episode ends with Lucy having a bit of a transformation. She goes from her jumpsuit to having leather and straps, something a little bit like Mad Max, which I think you can actually wear something similar to that in the Fallout games. So she's becoming a Wastelander, and that's cool to see. I don't have much to say about episode 5. When the power core was removed from the power armor and then basically made it useless, they had to leave it behind, which was really sad because it was just brilliant. I just enjoyed every moment of seeing the power armor in action. So it was quite disappointing that they had to leave it behind. We actually find out a bit more about Maximus's history. We learn that he lived in a place called Shady Sands. And I think Shady Sands might be mentioned in Fallout 1 or 2. I've not spent as much time with those two games as the others in the franchise, but I'm pretty sure it sounded familiar to me. Anyway, Maximus is from there. We get this flashback of him stepping out a refrigerator, which they show about, I don't know, 150 times in the whole season. And he makes reference to it as well when he's talking to Lucy about the bombs falling when he was young. So that's something that we're going to learn more about as the season goes on. Also, we start to get this mystery of Vault 31 developing, which is quite interesting. And then they go into Vault 32, and Norm is really surprised to find that it's been cleaned up. It's just very strange. There's something really weird going on in these vaults. Each episode opens with a unique title screen. And it was in the sixth episode that we got one from the game. It was that nice green nuclear effect that we all know and love. There was quite a strange scene in this one as well, where Maximus talks about a pimple exploding when he's talking to Lucy. It's just really strange. And for the first time, Lucy doesn't seem naive, it's actually Maximus, so their roles have reversed a little bit now that they're in a vault. Also, the development of the character Barb becomes particularly interesting in episode 6. She makes reference to the good vaults, so again, we know something's coming. And we see for the first time that Vault 4 is not what it seems. Lucy is warned not to go to level 12, which of course she ends up doing. Why do people never take the advice that they're given in TV shows? Meanwhile, Maximus is having the time of his life in his vault room. He's got a TV, which he's probably never seen before, a record player, he's having a hot shower, which he doesn't seem to know what that means, and of course, he gets to wear a dressing gown, which he really loves. And possibly I'd not picked up on it in the other episodes, but we actually hear the original Fallout theme that we get from the video games at one point in this episode. It's when Lucy's walking through the classroom in Vault 4, and I don't know why, I just got really excited by it. Also, there's a weird flashback where Cooper meets Moldava 200 years in the past, so I don't know how she's managed to survive that long and not age very much. And I'm not sure if that was answered in the series, but we'll talk about that when we get to the final episode. Episode 7, Lucy is confronted by the overseer of Vault 4, and she is asked what her vault's experiment is, and she has no idea about this. And I really like this one as well, because I remember when playing the games, you actually learn that basically every vault, there is some kind of experiment going on. And she just doesn't know what the experiment is for her vault. And we do actually get answers in the finale. We also see a red rocket diner. I think they're diners anyway. But that was really cool to see because they're part of the game, aren't they? As mentioned before, I was really upset when the power armor stopped working. So it was fantastic to see it back in action, albeit very briefly, when Maximus put it back on after stealing the power core. And then when he had to give the power core back, I was immediately left feeling disappointed again. There was also this really bizarre character. I think he was a snake oil salesman. First time we see him, he's trying to blow his own head off with a rifle. And then suddenly he perks up when he sees another survivor walking through the wasteland, who turns out to be Thaddeus, I think that's the name of the character. We then see him give some kind of concoction to Thaddeus that turns him into a ghoul, apparently. That was quite cool as well. The reason that we know that Thaddeus is a ghoul is because he gets shot in the neck. I was like, what? What's happened? Why is he not dying? He pulls out the arrow and he just doesn't bleed. It all heals up and we realise that he's become a ghoul. Just before that, we also get a little cameo from Fred Armisen. I know he's not everyone's cup of tea, but I quite like him, so it was cool to see him. Although he didn't say anything particularly funny, which I think is a missed opportunity there. Also, Norm's hacking one of the computers. I already mentioned my excitement at seeing a computer earlier, but when he's hacking it, he has the password screen, so that made me laugh as well. Again, if you've played the games, you know all about trying to hack the computers with the passwords. Episode 8 begins with another unique title screen. This time it's the black and white Fallout logo that we see a lot in the games. So again, that was quite a nice touch. Episode 8 actually does answer a lot of the questions that I'd written down as I was watching the series. I'm not used to taking notes when I watch a TV show, but I was doing it for you viewers, and I noticed that a lot of the questions that I had were starting to be answered in this particular episode. We find out about Vault 31. It's basically a chamber full of people that are being kept in some kind of stasis for hundreds of years. And as I mentioned before, I do wonder about Moldova. This is probably how she has managed to live through 200 years without aging very much. It's quite an interesting concept, isn't it? Buds, buds. They're basically trainee managers that have been kept on ice for 200 years. With the idea of bringing human resources and blue sky thinking to the world of the future.
Sometimes I'll start a sentence and I don't even know where it's going. I just hope I find it along the way. Like an improv conversation. Improvisation.
It's hinted at earlier that Barb is actually some kind of antagonist, and we find out in this scene that she was. And she gets to deliver the infamous line, "War never changes."
And war, well, war never changes.
Although Cooper then says it later as well. We get more slow-mo as the final battle happens. We also get the 15th or possibly 16th flashback to Maximus climbing out of a refrigerator aged 7. Lucy and Maximus have a heartbreaking split as he's left unconscious on the ground as she walks off into the distance with Cooper. Before leaving, she says, "I'll find you." And I feel like I've heard that somewhere before.
I'll find you.
Norm is stuck in Vault 31 and it seems like he's not going to be able to escape, so we're going to have to wait until Season 2 to find out if he does. We'll also need to wait and see if Maximus and Lucy will be reunited and able to build some kind of relationship. Although hopefully we won't get to see his pimple bursting. And the closing scene falls to Carl McLachlan, who I mentioned earlier should have had a bigger role to play in the show. As he walks through the wasteland, we're given a couple of clues as to what we can expect from Season 2. First, as the camera pans up, we see a skull, which to my eye anyway looked like a Deathclaw's skull. That's something to look forward to. And then finally we get to see where he is walking to, and to my eyes, it looked like New Vegas.
We three will wait for you. Even till eternity, my echo, my shadow.
I might have missed some other little clues in the closing scenes. If I did, please comment below, because I'd love to know what we have in store in Season 2. Overall, I enjoyed Season 1 of Fallout. When I first heard that Prime were making a show based on the Fallout franchise, I did feel a little bit apprehensive, I'll be honest. The trailer, which I did a reaction video to, card in the top right corner, made me feel a little bit better, so I did go into the first episode quite excited to see what was going to happen. Overall, I thought the pacing of the show was really good. It captures that kind of mundane travel at times that we all had to go through when we've explored the world, where you're going through the wasteland and there's not much going on for 10 minutes. But other than that, there was lots of action. The characters were pretty interesting, I think. There was plenty of mystery. It was scary in parts, and I did laugh quite a few times as well. I'm definitely on board to watch the second season when that comes out. What about you? What did you think of the first season of Fallout on Amazon Prime? Let me know in the comments. Also, if you've not seen it, possibly because you're not signed up for Amazon Prime, I will put an affiliate link down in the description and the top pinned comment, so you can sign up for a 30-day free trial. That'll give you more than enough time to watch all 8 episodes. Give the video a like if you've enjoyed it. Also, consider subscribing to the channel. Until next time, stay safe and keep gaming.